No one would have believed in the last update of Gmod that our servers were being watched from players on other servers. No one could have dreamed that we were being scrutinized as someone with a microscope studies creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. Few players even consider the possibility of so many bad players on these servers. And yet, across the gulf of the internet, minds immeasurably thicker to ours regarded our servers with envious eyes. And slowly and surely, they drew their contraptions against us. Gmod to its community is a Half-Life 2 modification setting the player free into a world of creation, imagination and fun. There are mainly two sides to the community, building and role-playing. Building consists of players creating imaginative contraptions and having fun with them with other players. Role-playing, on the other hand, is a totally immersive world where the player is accustomed to their own virtual life. The Gmod community consists of three main groups. The admins, who control and protect the server from harm.
Come on, let's go, go.
Admin police!
Hello? Who's in there? But Jesus Christ! What's that guy?
You'll never kill me, admin.
He knows when he's being tangoed. Let's go, let's move out.
The Mafia, who cause slight disruption to the game and usually own pizza places in servers, hitting on both admins and players.
Say goodnight!
What the hell are you doing? Jesus, don't go for it!
They usually owe the Mafia money.
You lousy bum, take that!
No.
And the citizens. Some are attention seekers, wanting to be noticed.
Hey guys, I'm jumping! You, is anyone there? Hello, I'm gonna, you jump. Anyone there? Oh, you, I'm jumping. No, not yet, in a minute. Okay. My life, RP has ended for me. And I'm jumping, look at you, come here, I'm going. Oh, you, oh yes, I'm going. Sonic, I'm jumping.
But most are just normal players, just wanting to have fun. Selecting their role in society, and carrying out to the fullest of potential. But then, there are those who are not spoken about by any player. They are in a class of their own. Those who cause war of the servers. It started at around 6 p.m. on the 21st of January when a huge mass of players erupted from the Gmod 9.04 server and sped towards our servers.
Hey, what's all the lag about?
As I watched the server lists, there was another lag spike. It was another player starting on its way. And that's pretty much how it was for the next 6 hours. Laggy players spurting out from these Gmod 9.04 servers. Morph, the server admin, assured me we were in no danger. He was convinced that there could be no danger to us from that remote, forbidding GMod 9.04 server.
Hey there! Whoa, lag! Do you feel that? That was crazy.
Yeah, I'm sure it's nothing to worry about.
The Warriors? That's my clan. They said it's happening everywhere. Hey, have you seen those new guys? They're weird.
Yeah, they arrived with a lag.
Hey, you wanna see my contraption? It's so cool!
No, I'm alright, thanks.
Awesome! Come this way!
The next day, there was a huge mess of contraptions in the middle of the map. I remember seeing this in another server. A red container with a dish-shaped model on top. Bits of wood and metal covered the area.
Who wants to buy a melon? Madam, would you like a melon?
No, you've already got some.
Nice. 2 for a gold piece. Get more there, Jake.
Watch out for that green man.
Melons for sale. 3 for a gold piece. Better than other roleplay servers.
It seems totally incredible to me now, how that everyone just spent that game as though it was just like any other. The admins not caring or noticing the laggy contraption in the middle of the map, and from the corner of the map came the sound of thrusters, welding and rumbling, softened almost into melody by the distance. It all seemed so safe and tranquil. The next game, I walked outside my house to find that it was actually foggy. I checked my GMOS settings, and they were fine. The fog wasn't even turned on. Quite confused, I ran down to investigate. Hey, admin, what's with the fog?
I didn't turn it on. I can't turn it off.
I noticed that there was a large crowd. I joined them to see what was going on. They were around that large mess of contraptions, hypnotized by the noise inside. Non-animated mouth lolled and giggled, and arms in non-motion stood still. A few young players crept closer to the container, but the motionless player faded into the back of the container. Pole rose from the disc with some kind of contraption attached to it. still not believing in what had just happened right in front of my eyes, and having no idea what it was, or what I was going to do next. I don't think anyone knew what they was going to do next. But whatever that thing was, knew what it was going to do next. At last, I had reached my player's house, and in the dim coolness of it, I wrote an account for my blog before I sank into a restless, haunted sleep.